Okay, so good morning, everybody. Are you able to hear?
Good morning, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So let's get started with continuing what we were doing last time. The last moment in last class, we're trying to see how to represent 32-bit constants. In the immediate operand, we know that the immediate operand is 16 bits. So we can easily load 16-bit, we can deal with 16-bit constants. And that is the normally we deal with 16-bit constants. Those are commonly occur 16-bit constants. But at times we might have to deal with 32-bit constants. For example, we want to load address of an array or something like that. So how do we go about it? Okay, for this we have to use two instructions. One is load upper immediate, and we give a 16-bit constant. And this constant gets loaded in the upper two bytes, the most significant two bytes. And the lower two bytes are set to zero. Once we execute load upper immediate, let's say in register S0, some number, some constant, let's say 61, it gets loaded in the upper two bytes, the most significant two bytes, and the lowest two bytes are set to zero. That's the effect of this instruction. And then it becomes very easy to set the lower bits. We use the instruction like OR immediate, and let's say we want to set 2304. So by using two instructions, we can load a constant, 32-bit constant. Now let's just recapture a little bit about the branch addressing. We had discussed last time, but just as trying to refresh. In the branch addressing, we have a 6-bit opcode, and there is a source register, and then we have this offset. Let's say we have, and also this offset can represent a forward direction or a backward direction. We can jump backwards or forwards. And what really happens is that this offset specified will actually is a word address. It's not a byte address, because we know that each instruction takes 4 bytes and we are just trying to jump over some instructions. We can no case jump less than 4, and therefore the least significant 2 bits are set to 0, and therefore we have this word address here. The offset is word address, or you can say number of instructions. So what really happens is that based on the offset we give, the current PC value is a byte address, and we add offset into 4. So just asking this question, that what is the maximum number of instructions that we can either jump backward or forward? What is the maximum number of instructions we can, using a branch address, at most, how many instructions we can branch? I mean, if it is a long program. Yes, anybody like to answer this?
64.
Just 54?
64, sir. 64.
64?
64? Yes, sir.
Just 64 instructions? See, we have 16 bits here. Okay.
So, to the power 16 instructions.
Word addresses. These are not byte addresses.
2 to the power 18.
So 2 to the power 16 instructions at once.
Okay, that is closure. But remember, we can jump backward or forward.
Okay.
Or 17 minus 4
is the maximum number of instructions we can jump backward or forward.
Sir, is it 2 power 17 minus 4?
Not that complicated. See, number of instructions, each instruction is one word, right? And we have 2 to the power 16 words or 2 to the power 16 instructions. As who answered that? I forgot to note down actually. Normally, I note down all these things. Archit, right? Yes. Archit. Archit was very near.
So, 2 Archit to the power 16 minus 1.
2 to the power 16. But minus then remember one. That it can be backward or forward. And if we want to represent that sign bit, we have 2 to the power 15. Anybody would like to argue with on this point? 2 to the power 15, maximum number of instructions. Either in the backward or forward, considering that it can be backward or forward. And if you consider it as bytes, then of course into 4, because each instruction is 4. Am I clear? Is anybody has doubt on this? Normally the answers, those who give answer and those who argue on these, etc., I note down, that's a very positive thing. And even the assignments, etc., that I give, and I get a mail from you, feel really happy. And those who ask their questions on mail really feel happy. I note that down. And just to tell you that in the assignment that I gave, I got 15 responses. And of course, I noted down all the names as usual. Okay, let's proceed. If nobody has any doubt here, we'll proceed. Now, what about jump address? In jump, we know that the opcode is 6-bit. And 26-bit is the address. But as we are saying that, this is not PC relative. We don't add this address to the PC value. And therefore, this address represents a code segment or text segment. So, if the text segment or the code segment, as it is called, the place where the program gets loaded. So, if 0 is the first one, and then the last one will be 2 to the power 26. Yes, so that's the maximum number of instructions that we can jump anywhere. If we specify the address is 0000, then it is the first instruction in the code segment. And it is the last instruction or the last place we can jump is 2 to the power 26, which is 128 million, right? Something like that. 2 to the power 6 in 2 to the power 20. But then the code segment, there are another 6 bits to that, which are extracted from the PC. The top 4 bits, okay, there are 6 bits, but then the least significant 2 bits will be zeros, because this address here in the jump is a word address, because it will jump over instructions, right? And each instruction is always 4 bytes. And therefore, the last 2 bits will be 0. And that leaves us the upper 4 bits. And that upper 4 bits will be extracted from the PC. So while computing the jump address, the upper four bits, that is 31 to 28, will be extracted from the program counter. And then the address that we specify, and the lower two bits, the lowest two bits will be 00. That we specify by address into four, the same thing. Anybody has doubt here? The jump and the jump and link instruction, the address implication is that each one is a 4-byte address. That means the lowest two bits are implicitly 00. And so, using this address, we can jump anywhere in the code segment from 0 to, it is not a relative addressing that we go forward and backward. It is the code segment, the total span that we can cover using this address.
So anybody has any difficulty? Yes, sir.
Yeah,
so Archit, how can we jump to an address that has a difference in the top four bits?
We don't. We cannot. Because, you see, here, as you know that there are different segments in the memory, the code segment, data segment, and so on, right? There are the operating system and so on. We don't jump there. We only at most start from the 0000 up to 1111, that is this 26 bit. And of course, as we are saying that in assembly programming, we don't really calculate the first instruction address, last instruction address, etc. That is for our understanding. Normally in assembly programming, we give labels. And as long as we say jump to a label, it is the assembler whose responsibility is to compute the exact address and put it there in the machine code. So that frees us from actually computing the address and so on. But this is for our understanding. And when we look deeper into the hardware, that is in the next class onwards, we'll see that we'll need this information. Yes, anybody would like to answer any question? Sorry, ask any question. Anybody would like to ask anything? Okay. But then the question comes, is that, see, if the branch is only to some 2 to the power 15 or something like that, what if we have a really large program, large assembly program, and we have given a label far, far away? Let's say something like BEQ, A0, S1, and L1, and this L1, we have written a large program. L1 is very far off. Can we do that, or it will give assembler error? Okay, the assembler, what it does is, see, if we are writing, giving a large number here, more than 2 to the power 15 or something, then it will not fit into the instruction. But what normally, if we use a label which is far off, what the compiler, the assembler does, it will translate this into these three instructions. What it will do is that it will use the far jump, which is a J, which is 2 to the power 26, instead of 2 to the power 15, which is restrictive. Here it will, what it will do is, if it is not equal, S0 and S1 are not equal, it just inverted this, and then L2, carry on here L2, otherwise do a far jump to L1. This is what the assembler does. Now let's write few code for functions, because last time we didn't do any exercise on function, C functions, how do we translate that to assembly code. If we have this increment function, which takes a pointer to an array, and an integer value. And it just sums, sorry, it just adds all, increments all element of the array by one. So let me just repeat here. This function takes a pointer to an array and the number of elements in the array. K is the number of elements. And what it does is, each element in the array, it increments by one. Now we want to write the MIPS code for this. So first one I will write, the next one I will need your help in writing. I will ask you to help me in writing. If it was a physical class, I would have called you to the board, but that's difficult here. We'll just take your help. I'll just ask you specific instructions. Now please observe this carefully. The first thing we do is we give a label whose name is incr. And while calling the function jump and link, we'll write incr, that's the place we'll jump. And then before calling this, we know that we have to put this address of the array in the register A0 and the number of elements in A1, register A1, before we call the function. Now there is a local variable here. We have to use another register to have this I, and then we will keep on incrementing I and then getting the element from the array and adding one and each time incrementing I until we reach K. So let's do that. Okay. We put incr, that's the label, that's the place where the function starts, and then we have done add t0, r0, r0. So I'll just ask randomly, just to check how you are doing with the code. Anand Jhuljhunwala, are you there? Anand, are you there? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Anand, you are there? Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes,
so,
sir.
Can you tell what does this instruction achieve?
Yes, sir.
It will add zero, R0, R0.
Yeah. It will add the value of R0 and R0 together in the register T0.
So, what will be the value of T0 at the end of this instruction?
2 times of R0.
Can you be more specific? What will be the value of T0?
Yeah, T0 will be equal to R0 plus R0. That is 2 times of R0.
No, I'm not very happy with your answer. Let's ask somebody else. Gaurav Govardhan Bishan. Are you there? So what will be the value of T0 after we execute add T0, R0, R0?
Most probably 2 times the value.
So you are also giving the same answer, right? Okay, let me just ask. Kitij Agarwal. Kitij, are you there?
Yes, sir. I also think 2 times the value of R0.
I am needing a better answer. That's why I am keeping on asking. I am not getting that answer. Pujita Mahesapa. Pujita, are you there? Pujita. Okay, we'll ask somebody. Radhika Gupta, are you there, Radhika?
Yes, sir. Hello, sir.
Radhika, can you give an answer? What will be the value of T0 register after this instruction is executed?
Sir, is it 0?
Yeah, very good. So Radhika says the answer will be 0. T0 will contain 0 because R0 is hardware to 0. Mm-hmm. Now, add T0, so now we put A0, which is the address of the array, in T1. So move A0 to T1, we write add T1 A0, R0. So now T0 contains 0, which is our I variable, and T1 we'll use for address computation. Basically, we have moved the array address A0 into T1. Now we set up this loop here, and we load the first element of the array. That is, whatever is there in the first address of the array 0T1 into T2. And then we increment T2, add 1 to that. And we store that back in the same address, T2 stored in 0T1. And then we add T1 with 4. This is to access the next element of the array. Because we know that in the, unlike the branch and jump instructions, where the immediate constant is a word or 4 bytes, in load word and store word, the immediate constant is a byte. Because we don't know, we might be accessing a character or an integer or something, and that's why the designers of MIPS language, assembly language, they have this immediate constant as a byte in load word and store word. Unlike the jump and branch where we specify a word, here we specify a byte in the store word and load word, and therefore we added 4 to that to indicate the next element of the array V. So first we accessed V0, now we are accessing V1. And then we are keeping count of how many elements we are accessing. So we incremented T0, which is our I basically. So I is incremented by 1. So first element we access, now the second element with incremented I, and then A1 contains k, the number of elements in the array. So as long as T0 is not equal to contents of A1, which is the number of elements of the array, let's say the array has 10 elements, we want to have this loop execute 10 times. So as long as T0 is not equal to 10, we go back to the loop here, branch not equal T0 A1 to loop. And if it is equal to 10 or something, whatever is there in A1, we return. Jump return based on the 31 register. Jump and return. And here we have no value to return to the calling procedure. That's how we had written the program. The C program wanted us to return no value. Just check here that it was a void here. And therefore, we did not copy anything to the V0, V1 register. We just returned. Now let's look at another program. Also, we don't want to return anything. Here, what we are doing is, we are swapping the kth element of the array V with the k plus 1 element. Simple C code here. The first argument is the address of the array, and the second element is a k, which is the place where we want to do a swap. The kth element and k plus 1 element we want to swap. And how do we do swap? We just have a temporary variable here. We just copy the vk value here into the temp, and then copy vk plus 1 into vk, overwrite vk, and then in vk plus 1 we store back temp. And that's how we achieve the interchange of the values of vk and vk plus 1. Simple C routine. Now we want to write the MIPS assembly code for this. Again, the first thing we start with is we have a label swap, and then we'll have this address computation. We'll use a register, and another register we'll use for this temp. Now let's so the address of the array is in A0, and the place where we want to affect the swap is in K. And here we have given swap as the name of the routine, and then we have done a shift left logical A12 into T0. So what does this achieve? Can I ask Pranay Joshi? Pranav Joshi, Pranav, are you there? Pranav? Okay. What about Raj Gupta? Raj? Raj, are you there? It's very difficult. See, if it is a physical class,
hello?
You can see that, yes, who is there. But Raj, are you there?
Hello?
Yes, Raj. So what, yes, does this achieve? SLL T0 A12. Raj, are you giving any answer?
Yes, sir. One second, sir.
Okay, we'll just ask somebody else. Shubham Maheshwari. Shubham, do you have any answer? Are you there, Shubham? Shubham Maheshwari, are you there? In physical class, we go and ask you there. But here it's difficult because I don't know whether your communication is on and so on. What about Bibhu Ranjan Jena? Bibhu Ranjan, are you there?
Yes, yes, sir.
What does the first instruction achieve? SLL T0 A12. And we know that A1 has the address of the first element of the array.
Sir, SLL stands for shift left logical.
Okay, so correct.
T0,
so what does this achieve?
T0 will have the left shift value of A1/2.
No, what does this achieve? Can you just be more precise?
So T0 would be equal to A left shift 2.
What is that? What is that? Can you be more precise?
So basically we are adding more bits at the LSB by 2.
Okay, I am looking for slightly better answer. Let me just try with Manavendra Singh Kuswa. Manavendra, are you there? Manavendra?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, Manavendra, can you give an answer? What does the first instruction achieve? SLL.
Sir, it will shift to left side. Left shift.
2 bits, okay, but what does that achieve? Can you give, that's what Bibhu Ranjan also told.
Sir, it means bit shifting, it does bit shifting, like it is like 1001, so it will shift left side and it will add, it will remove one from there, and it will
okay,
shift
left. That's what Bibhu Ranjan also said. I am looking for a better answer.
Sir, we will get 4 times of the A1.
Okay, good. Bibhu Ranjan says that we are multiplying A1/4. So basically, we are converting the word address into byte address, because load word and store word need byte address. They don't need the word address. So we are preparing T0 to have the byte address for the array from which you are trying to load. And then the second one, we are adding T0 and A0 and keeping in T1. Okay? So, A1 is the number of elements. Just look at the code in the this one, the problem that we are given here. So K into 4. So A1 was having K. Sorry. A1 was having K, so 4K it has. And now we have added the start address of the array with 4K, and that is the place where we want to do the interchange. Actually, we are having a slightly longer quiz today. That is for 18 minutes. So I think we have to stop here. We'll continue from this point in the next class. And Taisi, are you ready for the quiz? Taisi,
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay, very good.
Yes, sir,
okay.
The quiz is ready.
Yeah, so at the start of the quiz, just give a prompt. End of the quiz, give a prompt. So today quiz will be 18 minutes. And please look at your quiz question today. And please start as soon as the prompt is given and end after the prompt is given. Okay? As soon as the prompt is given, don't delay, because I get this complaint that we didn't could not submit and so on. As soon as the prompt is given, please submit. Don't delay too much, like a minute or something. Immediately submit. So we'll stop here. Continue from this point next class, and we'll look at deeper into the hardware. We'll complete our programming, assembly programming, and look deeper into the hardware from the next class. Thank you all.
Okay, so the quiz is about to start. I will let